So, dear friends, dear colleagues, it's a great pleasure to be a member of this to be faculty for this I think very important session. So, and tap technique is very popular in at least in Europe and as a basic technical approach during that interventional treatment of coronary bifurcation lesions. So the TAP allows us to stent the side branch as a bailout option, or we can go also by elective side branch stenting using TAP stenting technique. And definitely the bifurcation angle plays an important role in the primary decision making. We have to decide if we have to do bailout, perform bailout for the side branch stenting. So usually we have, in majority of cases, we have option to use TAP or culotte technique. And today the focus is TAP stenting, and you see there is of course option to achieve a gap in the side branch ostium or to have too large protrusion with a long neocarina, metal neocarina. I think this is important point. And usually if we go now with side branch stenting after usually predilatation and Kissing balloon maneuver, if we have here side branch dissection or timolol below 2 or residual stenosis more than 75%. So the next step will be to place the stent. And we have to, according to the complete coverage of the ostium, of the side branch ostium, we have to try to make a kind of protrusion to cover not only the ostium according to the distal carina, also to proximal carina. So that means that we distally usually have a kind of a protrusion. And to find this point is, I think, very important and very difficult. And usually we should have a protrusion of the side branch stent of around 0.5 millimeter. Please check this always in two different projection. Sometimes the stent is moving. sometimes patients is doing just deep performing very huge breathing, some breath maneuver, sometimes a problem of coughing, and this could provoke dislodgement of the stent. And to avoid this is one option to place the balloon in the main branch. So this is a kind of stabilization for the side branch stent. This is what we want to achieve. We want to achieve that our ostium is perfectly covered by stents and there is no huge protrusion. This is what we wish to achieve. If we have here suboptimal position of the side branch stent, like this here in this example. So there is a definitely a risk to achieve here a gap. This would be, of course, problematic because then we miss the ostium, maybe 1 or 1.5 millimeter, and this is sometimes a bigger problem. Or other option is the risk. Other risk is to achieve too large protrusion. So we have here 2-3 millimeters of the stent in the main branch. Side branch stent is protruded too much to the main branch, and this will be really not good culotte and not good and bad TAP approach. So how to manage this? And there is an option to do this. If we have here, if we implant the side branch stent and we have definitely 1-1.5 millimeter gap, so how to manage this? So one option is to start again with a second attempt with that technique. Usually we take a shorter one, shorter balloon, maybe 0.5 millimeter larger, and try again to achieve perfect position, suitable position, better position. And if this is still very crucial, if we believe this could be very difficult, I would suggest, and this is my approach in our center, that we just go with stand from the side branch to the proximal main branch, and make prolong the stand, make pot rewiring close to the carina, final casing, final pot. And this is a very suitable option to manage such situation in good way. And other option is if we have a long protrusion, large protrusion, and we implanted the stent and we see that the position is really not good, we usually can remove the wire, crash the sideburn stent. This is usually 2, 1, 2, 3 millimeters distance, so we can crush this and perform pot rewiring, final casing, final pot. And this is again quite good option to manage this correctly. And the problem is sometimes, like in this case, that we have here really difficulties to find optimal position for the tap. And what is very, very useful is a stand boost, or clear stand function, which is now a standard function in many cath labs. So you can use this technique, this function, to achieve perfect position for the side branch ostium stand. And as you can see, you can achieve quite acceptable result using this function. So in summary, TAP is still, of course, standard technique. Postdilatation casing with NC balloons is definitely obligatory. Imaging in form of IVUS, or especially OCT or Cleastand function, are very useful. And in case of large gap or large protrusion, please use a retap. This one option. Second option is conversion to culotte or conversion to mini crush or nano crush. Thank you and stay safe. Thank you. Bye-bye.